VLSI for all. Today we are will discuss some more interview questions based on digital electronics. Today we will discuss the questions about the topic FSM. Let's go to the first question. First question: what is finite state machine? Explain. Now, finite state machine is defined as a systematic way of specifying any sequential logic. We will go to finite state machine when we have the complex sequential logic. So these are used to recognize the patterns. Finite state machines automatically take the string as symbol as input and changes its state accordingly. The finite state machines has the two possibilities, that is, while having the transition, the automa can either move to the next state or stay in the same state. So that is, it can accept the state or reject the state. When the input string is successfully processed and the automata reaches its final state, then it will accept. So let's go to the next slide. Here let's consider an example, that is, if we consider a turnstile coin, when the current state is locked, we have here two states, locked state and unlocked state. If the current state is the locked, then if we give the input as coin, then the next state will move to the next state, which is unlocked. That means that we will get the output as the turnstile is unlocked so that the customer can push through. So if we give the push as the input for the current state, that is locked state, we will get the next state as also the locked state. So there will be no output. If we consider the second state, that is unlocked state, as the current state, if we give the input as the coin, then it will stay in the same state, that is unlocked state, as the next state, and there will be no output. If we give the input as the push, then it will go to the next state, that is locked state, and gives us the output that the when the customer has pushed through, lock the turnstile. This is one of the example of the FSM. In the FSM, we have mainly considered two models, that is Millet model and Moore model. Now we will go to the second question, that is, what is the difference between Millet and Moore FSM? In the previous question, we have discussed that FSM consists of two models, that is Millet model and Moore model. In these two diagrams, we will observe the difference between the Millet model and Moore model. Here we can observe that there is a red mark which shows us the Millet model depends on the input variable as well as the current state, whereas Moore model depends only on the current state. So before going to the diagram, let's see the table. Here this table gives us the differences between Moore machine and Millet machine. Here, as I have said before, in the Moore machine, output depends only upon the present state, whereas in the Millet machine, output depends on the present state as well as the present input. Whereas Moore machine also places its output on the transition, Millet machine places its output on the transition. Here, in Moore machine, we will require the more states, whereas in Millet machine, it requires the less number of states, that is compared to the Moore machine. In Moore machine, we require the less hardware for circuit implementation, whereas in Millet machine, we will require more hardware for circuit implementation. Moore machine reacts slower to inputs, and Millet machine, they react faster to inputs, because in Moore machine, the output, we will get the output after the one clock cycle later, so it reacts slower to the inputs. So Moore machine is synchronous output and state generation happens, whereas in Millet machine we will get the asynchronous output generation. Moore machine output places on states, and Millet machine output is placed on the transitions. Here, while coming to the design, in Moore machine it is easy to design, and in Millet machine it is difficult to design. These are some of the differences between Moore machine and Millet machine. So this is the diagram which tells us about the main difference between Millet machine and Moore machine. So we will go on to the next question. Here, in the previous question, we have discussed what is the difference between Millet machine and Moore machine. We can came across a doubt that which is better, that is Millet or Moore FSM, and why. That we will discuss in this question. So here, when coming to the Millet and Moore FSM, Moore is more stable state machine model, as its output changes at the clock edges, Whereas Millie changes his output asynchronously. That means whenever there is a change in the input, we will get the change in the output, which may cause the difficulties. So Millie machine have the advantage of, even though we have observed that Millie machines have the advantage of requiring less states, since one state can produce a number of different outputs in combination with the input. Whereas Moore machine state, on the other hand, only produces one output. So Moore machine is more stable in this regard. So it only indirectly react to input changes. So this is the main problem in Millie, that it depends both on the input and the present state. If there is a change in the input, then it will automatically affect the changes in the output, which may cause the effect on the changes in the output. So this causes the triggering effect of the output, and which is not helpful in the practical situations. Even though we can see that Millie has the less number of states and Moore requires more number of states, but Moore is more stable because it doesn't change its inputs continuously. It has the output change only at the clock edge. So we will move to the next question. That is, what are the applications of FSM? We have come across so many questions before, that is, what is FSM and Millie and Moore FSM and difference between them, and what are the applications. Now we will go to the what are the applications of FSM. In daily life, we will come across many applications of FSM if we observe them. So here are some of the applications of the FSM. Those are vending machines, traffic lights, video games, text parsing, CPU controllers, protocol analysis, natural language processing, speech recognition. These are some of the applications of FSM which may come across in our daily life. So if we observe vending machines and traffic lights, video games, these are mainly we will come across in our daily life. We will observe them also. So these are some of the questions today based on the FSM in digital electronics. We will meet with some other questions in the next video. Thank you.